we must decide whether or not we're going to be controlled by circumstances or by the influence of the Holy Spirit as He guides us and reminds us of the Word of God. Or circumstances will continually affect us to whether to drive us into directions that our emotions may take us, or other people's advice may take us, or past experiences may control us, or what kind of frustrations we have had in dealing with similar situations. So if we are always being directed by circumstances, and the Word of God would have only reflective influence. What I mean by that is when things get bad, when things are not going well, then we will look for a word from God, or we will seek to find advice from someone who has good knowledge of the Scriptures. This is how we will be. And the people that were successful in life, that became great, powerful influences in their time, were people who were in jail for 12 years, Joseph, Daniel, who was constantly going through people, cutting him on the job, talking behind his back, trying to find ways to get him removed from his position that irritated them when he was promoted above them. You have Paul, who will go to the Gentiles only to irritate the Jewish leaders so that they would constantly follow him around until they could find a way to kill him. You see, what we find in Scripture are people whose circumstances didn't make them anxious for nothing. These circumstances so refined their commitment to Christ that they were content in every situation they experienced. This is what leads us to where the world can be under duress and stress, but our hearts could be at peace, because the end result of walking in the Word of God under the influence of the Holy Spirit is that the fruit of the Spirit produces strength for long-suffering, peace, joy, self-control. It gives us kindness even when we're being treated ugly, because the fruit of the Spirit becomes our strength. Stay focused.